Hi everyone, it's Kathy Zilski. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I have got a very bold, fun card project featuring some brand new neon inks from Rena K of Gina K Designs. This new electropop ink line is really fun and it is so bright and colorful. So let's dive in and look at the products. The colors I'm using today are Poppin' Pink and Potent Purple. They live up to their names. There are actually 8 colors in this new ink release, and they are bold and vivid and fantastic. So I will be using those as well as a bit of Key Lime from Gina K's regular ink line and a little bit of her embossing ink as well. I've got my favorite white powder from Brutus Monroe and a tiny blender brush that I'll be using, some Comfort Blocks, and this die that is from me. It's a new release. It's just called Mom and Dad, and they are word and shadow layers. So you can cut out the word and have a shadow layer behind it. I'm gonna use some old stamps. Well, old, these are a couple years old, from Simon Says Stamp. This is called Bold Flowers. And yes, I have been stamping with the Electropops, and don't be discouraged when your stamps change color because it just means they're good quality and they're porous. I also have the coordinating dies. For my sentiment, just one little sentiment from my collection called Simple Sentiments 2. Lots of just all-purpose sentiments in there. And a little embossing. This is a folder from Tim Holtz. And I've got lots of white cardstock today. I've got Nina Solar White Classic Crest in 2 weights, the 110 and the 80 pound. I'm going to start out with the Poppin' Pink, but I just wanted to show you the difference in size. So this is Rena's ink pad. And that's a regular Gina K cube. So the Electropop is actually more similar in size to like a Tim Holtz Distress Pad or Distress Oxide Pad, the full size. I'm gonna get it inked up really well here. And I thought I would do some stamping without my Misty because I'm trying to increase my skill. And this ink actually does transfer pretty well. I mean, that's a one-time stamp down. And I always stamp extras because I always make mistakes when I'm die cutting. And now I'm gonna clean my stamp off, but I wanna show you this cute container that was sent to me. This is from Make It by Marco. They also make glue holders, which you'll see in just a few minutes here in the video. But it's designed to hold your stamp chamois or your tidy towel. I keep my tidy towel in here, and it doesn't get smelly. And yes, if you leave it overnight, it might dry out and you just re-wet it down, but it's so great because nothing gets smelly. And that stamp is actually clean. Now when I went to stamp the purple flowers down, I was not getting the impression that I wanted, and I think my pad either was, it might have been a little dry. So I just went back to the Misty because I wanted more purple flowers. When in doubt, pull out your Misty stamping tool because the beauty of it is you can hit it in the same exact location twice, and that is exactly the coverage I wanted. So I stamped a few extras. I decided to take a couple more of Gina K's regular inks, the Passionate Pink, which is actually a really bright, vivid pink, but in comparison to the Poppin' Pink, it just looks like a nice neutral complement. And I used Wild Lilac for the center of the purple flowers. Now here's the funny thing about Key Lime. Key Lime was one of the brightest inks in Gina K's collection. It is a fantastic bright lime green, but compared to the Electropops, it's like just a soft, subtle green. And that's what's so crazy to me about how bold these neon inks from Rena K really are. I absolutely love Key Lime, so I stamped a bunch of greenery to set aside for use on the card. Now I'll cut out the word and shadow, and what I'm going to end up doing here is instead of cutting a bunch of the word layers, I'm actually going to cut extras of the shadow layer. Because I think it's going to be easier to glue those together, and I don't know why I don't do this more often. But I want to add color just going direct to paper with my Poppin' Pink pad to create a perfectly matching mom word for this card. Because I've got my pink flower, and now I'm going to have a perfectly matched word. I'm using this little blending brush just to get the edges so that everything is covered in that pink. And I'll set that aside to dry. Now here's my glue holder. Isn't that cute? A little rainbow. There are different sizes for different types of glue bottles. This works great for my Connect glue, and I always keep a little paper down there in case my glue gets runny, which will happen sometimes. And I'm just going to glue these shadow layers together. I'm gonna glue 3 of them together to create a nice dimensional base for the word mom. Again, I've never actually done this. I always do the word, but I thought this is actually a little easier for me. I have trouble sometimes getting the word dies all lined up perfectly, but that looks pretty good. So I will just set that aside to dry. I'm using the coordinating dies and holding them in place with a little bit of purple tape from ThermaWeb, and I will also get the dies for the greenery as well. Just running those through my Spellbinders Platinum 6, and out comes my flowers. I'm using this little texture fade folder from Tim Holtz, just a Swiss dot, putting that right on the platform and then putting my embossing plate over the top, running that through the die cut machine, and I emerge with this beautiful panel of texture. And I use the 80-pound weight for that just to get a nice, easily embossed impression. I'm scoring my card base. This is a standard US A2 card size. I like to tape my card bases closed just because the cardstock is so thick that it pops up a little and I need everything to be flat. I'll use a little dot runner here on the back. I didn't want to pop up the embossed panel because I really just wanted it there for texture, but not a lot of bulk. And then off camera, I stamped, embossed, and trimmed down this little sentiment and added a bit of foam adhesive to the back. Now I've kind of laid this out where I think it should all be. I'm not great with floral arrangements, but that doesn't stop me from trying. I think this turned out really nicely, but I'm working my way through adhering the greenery right to the embossed panel, and I did want those leaves to hang out a little bit into the white non-embossed margin. I thought that looked nice. And then I've just got a little bit of foam adhesive on those flowers. I put two foam squares on the center pink one so that that would be a little bit taller than the purples. And then I'm using the liquid adhesive to put the mom on, placing that down and just letting that set up, and then adding the sentiment right below. It's actually a really simple card, and that's where I think you can really take these bold, bright neons and use them in a really simple and elegant way. But I think the color on this is just fantastic, and I encourage you to check out these new Electropop inks, especially if you are a fan of neon, because if you are, you are going to love them. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you back here with another card video soon.